Hi there, Jacob Rohrbach here from Dark Fire Productions, doing part 2 of the Dreamland vlogs. In this part, I'll be showing you the entire movie, at least all we've shot, every scene edited the way it was supposed to be, and color-corrected the way I had it back then. So, I'll be showing you the entire movie from start to finish, and whenever there's a scene that we don't have enough footage for, we didn't shoot, or just something went wrong, I will come on camera, describe the scene, and tell you what happened. So, with that out of the way, let's start the movie. So, scene 4, it's an interesting one. We shot this scene about 3 different times and we never got it right. First time we shot it was day 2, and you can find all this footage, basically, on the first trailer I released, the March Hare trailer. As you can tell, that footage doesn't look like anything we shot now, because we used someone else's camera with a slightly better mic. That's the only reason, really, we used it. Then I decided, let's reshoot that, because we wanted to use this camera, and just, we could do better, honestly. That kind of fell apart due to rain issues. It would always rain when we were trying to do these scenes.
I was just following this light.
Light? And for the third time, we just shot Kayla's lines because Ethan and Zach were busy, so we just shot all of Kayla's lines, and then I was gonna have Ethan's line done another day, but we never got around to it. So for this scene, what was supposed to happen is she walks in, she talks to the March Hare and Mad Hatter. So March Hare would talk to Alice, try to basically interview her. There'd be a lot of Alice in Wonderland references I couldn't fit in, like, on birthdays and stuff like that. And soon, March Hare would devise a plan on how to capture Alice for Ace. Alice then started getting worried and wanted to leave, so March Hare would stick Mad Hatter on her. She'd run, she trips, falls, and then the Cheshire Cat, Shay, would come out, grab her, and just vanish. It's a scene I really wanted to do badly, because I really like that scene. Ethan, Zach, and Kayla are all fun to work with. So, it's kind of a disappointment we don't have this footage. I would have put the first time we shot this footage on here, but we lost all that when the hard drive broke that I had. And that is basically scene 4, the Hatter and Hare scene. Absalom, get over here.
Yes, sir. You summoned me, sir?
I want you to look at this.
It's a girl, sir.
Yes, a girl. An outsider, to be exact.
An outsider?
You seem surprised, Absalom.
Well, sir, I sort of am.
But it was your plan.
True.
Your plans never fail.
That they don't.
Then what?
We got the human in the Dreamland.
Do you underestimate power, Absalom?
No, sir. No, just a little surprise, that's all.
Do you have our next move planned?
No, not yet.
The girl! I want the girl.
Well, the Hatter and Hare.
No, it's too late. The cat already got her.
What do we do?
The twin! The one we captured. What is the name?
Dom?
Yes. Bring it to me. Now.
Yes, sir. At once, sir.
Sailor's life is a life for me. How I love to sail on the bounding sea. I never, never, ever give a care about the weather, for the weather never, ever gives a care for me.
Oh, sailor's life is a life for me. How I love...
Excuse me?
Well, hello there, Missy.
Do you know where I am?
Where are you? Who are you?
I'm Alice.
Glad to meet ya. Bill's the name. What brings you down this rabbit hole of a world?
I don't know. I sort of just appeared here.
Don't we all?
Are you drunk?
Are you blind? Dearie, this ball's been empty for years. I've given up. I accept my fate.
What?
Death, my friend. We're all gonna die. You, me, and hopefully Ace. But that's not likely. Long live Ace, they cheered. Long life to... It's made.
Then why are you drinking it?
Perception, my dear. It's all how you perceive it.
What?
Perception. Just like the unanswerable question.
And that would be?
How is a raven like a writing desk?
Oh, because Poe wrote on both.
What part of an answerable don't you understand?
Hey, it's all about how you perceive things.
Now you're getting it. What did you say her name was again?
Alice. Alice Liddell.
What? Alice?
Yeah?
You're the one she and the other talking about.
Who?
You should ask a lot of questions.
Well, you are moving a bit fast.
Come with me. I'll be so happy to see you.
Wait, where'd she go?
Shay, what's wrong? Where have you been?
I just had her. She was in my arms. Where is she?
Who are you talking about?
Alice. I found her.
You did? Where is she?
I don't know. One second I saved her from the Hatter and Hare, and now she isn't here.
Maybe she was teleported somewhere else. That happens once in a while.
That's what I worry about. What if she went somewhere even worse?
I'm sure she's fine.
The only reason I found her was because of the beacon. How are we supposed to find her now?
I don't know, but panicking about it won't help.
Besides, Bill's out there. He might run into her.
Yeah, or he's out there getting drunk as usual.
She does have a point.
I'm sure he'll be sober enough to recognize her. I bet that's him now.
I'm back!
I can see this.
And where exactly have you been?
Well, I was at my usual drinking spot.
See? I told you.
Let him finish at least. Please continue.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Anyways, like I said, normal drinking spot, contemplating life and such, like usual. And suddenly, this person appeared out of nowhere. Shay, Dee, Queen, let me introduce you to Alice Liddell.
One more.
Bill, is this really her?
You bet.
Do you know what this means?
Dreamland is saved.
Excuse me?
So, interesting story about this. We forgot to shoot the rest of the scene. I don't know what happened, but we never shot it. This scene was supposed to have the rebellion tell Alice all about the prophecy and how she's the only one who could save him because she has the power, because it's kind of all in her head. But we forgot to shoot everything, and thus we kind of had to cut this scene short.
Before then, I used to protect Dreamland. It used to be a happy place. Beautiful, in fact. But then Ace began taking down the most powerful people of the land, including the king. And with no one to stop him, he began his terrible rule. With the help of his assistant, Absalom.
You couldn't stop him? I'm afraid I was the only one left. And I couldn't fight a battle by myself, so I went into hiding and started a rebellion on my own.
Sadly, we're all that is left. Ace managed to kill all of them, anyone that got in his way. The survivors, including my sister Dom, were kept in the asylum as slaves.
So where do I fit into all of this?
You are the only person who is more powerful than Ace.
Me? How am I more powerful than Ace? I don't know how to fight. I don't know how to do anything.
Not right now, you can't. But we will help you become stronger.
But why me? Alice, you are the power of Dreamland. You may not know it, but you have a lot of power. We just have to unlock your true potential.
This is too much to handle.
We understand. Maybe you should get some rest.
No, this is all just a bad dream and none of this is real.
I can assure you this is very real. We need your help, Alice.
No, no, just stay away from me. I don't want any part in this.
What are we going to do? We can't force her.
Just give her a while. She needs some time to adapt.
I hope you're right. Dom, I'm here.
Dee!
you're there, everything will be okay.
How is everyone? It's been so long.
I know. It's getting harder and harder to connect with you. But soon enough, we'll get you, sis. I promise. We're doing fine. We're holding up. How are you? How are you doing?
It's so terrifying here. I can hardly sleep anymore. The guards are always watching.
Yeah. Shay told us stories about how terrible those men can be. Now look, you need to protect yourself, Dom. Don't let them lay a finger on you, understand?
Yes, I understand. It's going to be hard, though. They don't give you much air.
Just be cautious for a little longer. We're going to save you very soon.
What makes you say that?
Well, guess what just happened?
What?
We sent out the beacon like we usually do.
What is it? Come on!
This time, it actually worked. Bill brought Alice to the base.
Wait, did you say Bill?
Yeah.
The lizard makeup guy.
Yeah? Why?
I keep seeing him stumbling through the blocks. Nobody does anything about him, so I just assumed he worked for Ace.
Oh. Oh no.
What?
He sort of ran off after he gave us Alice. I just assumed he was drinking again.
You don't think...
Dom?
No, I'm waking up!
I'll try to alert the others when I wake. Take care of yourself.
Bye, sis. Hope to see you soon.
Come with me.
I brought her, sir, as you requested. I'm sorry, sir. Come over here.
Is this a twin?
Yes, sir. This is Dom, sister of the Rebel D. Both of the Tweedle family, as you requested.
Good. Absalom.
Sir?
You read a lot of books, don't you?
Yes, I do, sir. Plenty of books.
Do you know anything about a special ability that twins share?
Well, I've read various theories, both fictional and non-fictional, that there is a belief of a psychic link.
A link?
Yes, a link. Between the minds.
Tell me, what's your name?
I told you, sir. Her name is...
I asked her! Now tell me, what is your name?
Dom, sir.
Now, Dom, do you share any special link to your sister?
I don't know.
Well then, let's find out. You gotta start noticing a pattern with these hideout scenes. After we forgot to shoot the second half of that previous stuff, we never really shot the rest of what we had afterwards. Like, this scene, we have most of it shot, we just don't have any of Rachel's lines done. So, in this scene, it's just supposed to show from Dee's point of view of her being possessed by Ace at the moment due to the psychic link. So she'd get up, look around, and she'd see Alice. Throughout that time, we'll be hearing a monologue from just Ace doing commentary because I just need to fill that dead air. And the moment she sees Alice, she collapses and Ace is done possessing her.
Now if only I knew where they were.
Absalom.
Yes, sir.
Where is the lizard?
You called, sir?
That was fast.
I wouldn't want to disappoint the master.
Are you drunk?
Are you blind?
What did you just say to me? I trust you have the location of the rebellion.
Of course I do. They're at the old library, they're to the border.
Interesting choice. Absalom.
Yes, sir.
I'm done with the girl. Take her away.
Right. Anything else?
Yes. Bring me the Undertaker.
The Undertaker?
Did I stutter?
No, sir. I'll get her right away.
Good. And be quick about it, too. I don't know how much time we have left.
Yes, sir. I'll get her before you can say
go!
Yes, sir!
So scene 13 is another hideout scene, and it's just Dee waking up and everyone talking to her about it. And then we get more exposition of why Dreamland characters can't really dream, because then it gets into some weird inception stuff. And then it starts going into the past of Dreamland, saying like, oh, the king had this power to control people's minds, and it hints at you that when Ace kills someone, he takes their powers. But we also have most of the scene shot, but it was just the fact that we filmed this on a Super Bowl Sunday, I think it was, and Rachel was busy helping her family with stuff, and the only people free were Emily and Sadie. Really, it was just a matter of we didn't have enough stuff shot.
Hello? It's only a dream. Oh, thank God.
So you're gonna see me a lot more now, because we're getting to the point where, like, every other scene, we didn't film. But this one has a special story behind it, because we shot the scene 5 times, but we never finished it because someone was never free or I had to recast someone. This is a courtroom intro, I call it. From that previous scene, when Alice walks out of her room, she walks into Ace's lair in full costume again. And Ace is basically putting some exhibition out there saying, this is my courtroom, I'm gonna put you on trial, I'm basically gonna execute you. Then Absalom comes in, says, the Undertaker's here. Alice uses this opportunity to hit Absalom with the door and leave. Ace explodes on Absalom, basically strangling him the entire time when he's screaming, why'd you let her go? You had one job, stop the girl. And during that, Alice is thrown back in by the Undertaker, and we're introduced to that character, who is Ace's bounty hunter. From there, he dismisses Absalom, he goes outside, and that's the end of that scene.
You okay?
What? I'm sorry, what?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
No, you're not. What happened in there?
The usual crap. I try to serve Ace, I fail, I get my face shoved in the dirt again. The usual.
So why do you keep on serving him?
Are you crazy? He'd get me killed. Besides, it was my fault anyway.
How so?
I failed to do a single task, keep Alice in the room. Can't even do that. Can't even stop a little girl from leaving the room. How pathetic is that? Then there's that blasted Undertaker.
You shouldn't let him get to you like that.
I can stop him.
It's not your fault Alice got away.
How do you do it?
Hmm?
How do you be just so carefree about everything?
I just stopped caring.
I mean, think about it. You're betraying the only people who actually trust you. The only people who don't beat you into a pulp every 5 seconds. I just don't... How do you do it, Bill?
I just stopped caring.
You remember the Jabberwock?
No.
The Jabberwock! Used to reside in the care of woods? You know. Beware the Jabberwock, my son! The teeth that snatch, the claws that catch.
Well, there's not much to be afraid of now. What is it, like, a rug or something?
It's a furniture set. The Bandersnatch was a rug.
That's right. What about the Jub-Jub bird? Didn't Ace make things like a stew?
No. Now you're just forgetting things. The Jub-Jub bird was plucked and served, cooked, as all birds should be. Some oysters on the side, there was some turtle soup, some tea, I got food poisoning, that was fun. Well, I think that'll be enough for today, my friend.
Your loss. just cider.
Well, color me surprised.
Hey.
Oh,
sailor's life is a life for me. How I love to sail on the bounding sea. And I never, never, ever give a care about the weather, for the weather never, ever gives a care for me. Oh, a sailor's life is a life for me.
So remember when I said the last scene I took 5 times? This probably took more, because we have done this scene numerous times. But this scene is the trial scene. It's when Alice is held on trial, which meant she was just handcuffed to a chair and I was just talking over her. Ace would then explain her crimes of entering Dreamland and not being a resident here, because there was a law of no outsiders being in Dreamland. Alice would try to plead that she's innocent, and then Ace would start bringing in various witnesses. And by witnesses, he means just some more chair who would talk about how she was breaking the law. Ace would find her guilty, teleport her to the isolation room, and then he'd send the Undertaker after the rebellion, which he would give her the locations through cards he had that were introduced in the beginning. Next, Alice would get teleported and wake up into the isolation chamber.
In, teleported into your cell and took you out, just like I escaped years ago.
Well, couldn't you have done that earlier?
No, I had to wait till Ace was gone. I couldn't risk being caught. Speaking of being caught, we have to meet up with the rest of the group before we're caught here.
Think we should tell Ace? Absalom? Oh my God. Should we tell Ace?
No, no. Let's keep this one to ourselves, eh?
If you say so. I'm head back inside, though.
Well, go on. What's this? Oh, it's the Master's card. It's the Master's card! Oh, I must have forgotten when he yelled at me. Again? Why would he do that? I mean, I do everything he asks me for, and more, and what does he give me in return? A swift kick to the teeth! Hell, if it wasn't for me, he'd still be where he was. It was my ideas to dominate Dreamland. It was my idea to brainwash residents. It was my ideas to use his powers to... It was my idea to use his powers to keep track of the residents with these cards. I'm a genius! The Master will surely be pleased that I can get Alice for him.
Have to relocate, so thus we found this little place.
But why?
Well, when you were captured, we came to a realization. Ace used my sister Dawn to read my mind and locate where you are. That's why this incident happened last night.
And thus, we now have to travel almost daily, so we cannot fully pin our location down.
Are you all right?
Never been better.
But what's stopping him from doing it again?
Well, Alice, nothing. He could find us right now if he wanted to.
But we have a plan.
I got it!
Speak of the devil.
What is that?
It's a map of Ace's lair, which used to be my throne.
This is great!
During my rule, I used to keep maps and blueprints of every major place in Dreamland. It just took some sneaking in and finding it.
Oh, makes sense.
So, what's the plan?
The only thing I figured we can do is try to rescue Dom. After we do that, we can settle for a bit and try to figure out our next move.
But wait, why can't Shay just teleport in and get Dom?
It's not that simple. The place is too heavily monitored, especially where Dom is. I could be killed the minute I enter that cell.
That is why we need to figure out a way to take out the monitors.
Wait, I have an idea. But you're not going to like it.
We could use anything right now. What is it?
Well, we could use Alice as a distraction.
Wait, what? I hate to say it, but it just might work.
Do you hear what you're saying? I'm not going back there.
Sorry, hon, but we might just have to.
But Alice, it won't be long. It's just enough time to rescue Dom. I will not return to that isolation chamber. I'm not going back.
Isolation room?
Yes, Shay rescued me from the isolation chamber, as Ace called it.
How long were you in there?
I don't know. I couldn't focus. There were voices in there and they were driving me insane.
Do you think this means...
I think so.
What are you talking about?
If we're correct about this, we might not have to wait to attack.
Can someone please explain to me what's going on?
Dear, being in the isolation chamber basically put you through a forced adaptation. You're like us now.
Hold on, how does being tortured adapt me? Alice, it means you are able to unlock your full power. You have become part of Dreamland.
Woo?
With a little training, we can finally kill Ace.
So does this mean we can scrap the idea of using me as bait?
Yes, but we need to prepare you for battle.
Okay.
Just come with me.
Sir? I don't remember calling you, Absalom.
Yes, sir, but I have something for you. A plan.
A plan, you say?
Yes, sir. It's simple, really. We use these cards of yours, and...
Where'd you get this?
I forgot to get it back!
You forgot? You forgot?
I'm sorry!
Whatever rebellion got a hold of this?
I'm sorry, Ace!
What did you call me?
I'm sorry.
Get up. I said get up! Get up! I said get up! No, get out of my sight!
Yes, sir.
So, remind me what this is supposed to do. We have to figure out what you can do before we send you off to fight Ace.
But I don't even know how to fight.
You don't need to. Just act on impulse. It's quite simple, really.
Now you ready?
And go!
Come on! Quit holding back! You can do this!
Thank you. Impressive, Alice. Impressive. Though, I wonder, what do you plan to do with these new skills, eh? Oh, don't worry. I'm here to help.
How can we trust you?
I don't expect you to trust me, Your Highness. I came asking for help.
Bill said the same thing. Now look what happened.
Ah, yes. But not a day goes by that he doesn't regret that decision.
We aren't giving you Alice if that's what you want.
If I wanted her, I could have had her by now. I come to you with a proposition.
What are you talking about?
I want to assassinate Ace. You see, ever since his rise to power, Ace... he's changed. I mean, at the beginning, I was his right-hand man. I made the plans, he executed them. There was a few undesirables, but he was like that, remained a good man, and everything was good. Then, slowly, all that power went straight to his head and stuck there. Now I am nothing more than dirt under his shoe to stamp. I'm tired. I'm tired of his abuse, tired of his constant torture, torment, his acts. He deserves to be punished. He deserves to be given justice for his crimes. He deserves, above all else, to die.
How do we know you're telling the truth?
Look here, Alice, Your Majesty, Twin Cat. I am your only link to Ace. Now you can either accept this offer given to you on a silver platter, or by all means, you can leave it.
Okay, you're in.
Wonderful. A map of Cheshire Prison?
And so we can save Dom.
The twin?
My sister.
Well, this is going to be useless. This is what we're going to need. A map of Dreamland. Here is where Ace spends his days. The quickest, I will distract him so that he won't see any of you coming. The quickest way to here is through, I believe, the West Carroll Woods, here. Now, I am going to do my best to distract him so that he doesn't see any of you coming. While I am doing that, I need you. Can I help you?
What about Dawn?
What about her?
We are going to find her.
She is not important in this situation.
She is important to me! Guys, we can't be doing this. Absalom, tell us how we can rescue Dom. That way we can do something while Alice tries to take down Ace.
Fine. I can try and distract Ace a little longer, but I can't and I won't guarantee anything.
So now about this plan to take down Ace.
There we go! Something I'm actually interested in. Now, here's the plan. So, give me about 10 minutes and then come out. Sounds simple?
10 minutes. Call. Got it.
Good. We might actually stand a chance. So, why do you trust them?
Pardon?
The first few people you meet, and you instantly trust them.
Well, the first two people I met didn't leave much of a good impression.
Hatter and Hare? Or they grow on you?
I highly doubt that.
It's true. To be honest, no one used to be like they are now. It's like when Ace took over, everyone became the exact opposite of what they really were.
Even Shay and the others?
Especially them. I mean, a little group of nothings who had nothing to do with each other suddenly get together and plot to take down the most powerful man in Dreamland. It's quite amazing, actually.
Yeah, that's how it is at home, too. Wait, what's this?
May I?
Sure.
Oh, no.
Absalon, you traitorous worm!
Ah, Undertaker. I forgot about you. Then again, you aren't that worthy of remembering.
I'm here for my bounty. Get out of my way, and we can make things a lot easier.
And what are you going to do?
Absalon, you don't have to do this.
On the contrary, Alice. I have some unfinished business with her. But don't worry. This won't be long.
Are you okay?
Ace has a harder backhand than that. No!
What? Why?
Trust me. There is no one else on Earth who wants her more dead than I do. But right now, she's no good to anyone dead. Trust me. Not so fast. I need you to deliver a message for me.
Fine. What do you want?
Tell the Master that an army is coming. Tell him that his reign will be over before the sun sets tonight. Can you do that? Good. Now, off you go.
This is not the last you've heard of me.
I hope for your sake it is. Let's move on, shall we?
Who is that woman?
She's a bounty hunter for Ace.
I remember her from the trial. Isn't her name the...
Undertaker, yes. Not much is known about her, except for stories.
Stories? What kind of stories?
Legends of a bounty hunter whose ability has never failed Ace. Not once. Never failed any mission of any kind. In fact, she's the next best thing to Ace's power.
Well, are you all right?
Oh, yes. I've suffered much worse beatings than that.
You have?
Oh, yes.
You really shouldn't take that much abuse from him.
It's not like I haven't heard that a million times before.
You do know they say that for a reason.
Well, this is where we part ways, my friend. I don't think we'll ever see each other again. Best of luck to you.
You as well.
And thank you for being one of the few people to be kind to me. I truly appreciate it. Goodbye, Alice Adele. Thank you, and good luck.
Goodbye.
Oh, a sailor's life is a life for me. How I love to sail over the bounding sea. And I never, never, ever give a care about the weather.
So this scene, I actually wrote in later, just to give character to Shay and the Queen. showing their personalities more. It's basically, the queen walking up to one of the cars in the background, feeling it, trying to hope it's warm, and they have a whole conversation about how the queen isn't really optimistic about this, but Shay believes that Alice can do it. And it was supposed to be this really touching scene between Sadie and Rachel that we just never had time to film.
I'm disappointing you, Absalom.
Yes. Please, forgive me, sir. Forgive me.
Forgive you?
Yes, please, sir. It was a moment of weakness.
A moment of weakness? You betrayed me! You attacked one of our own, and you called that a moment of weakness?
Please, sir. It was Bill. He put me up to it.
I don't think so.
What? Why is that?
Have a look at this. Go ahead. Open it. You know, I've been doing some thinking lately.
About what, sir?
Well, ever since my takeover, I've been doing all my work from here.
That you have, sir.
I then begin wondering, what have you done since my rise to power?
Help you take down the rebellion.
Which has been reduced to 3 now.
4. Forgive me, sir. Only being exact.
Anyway, I know you've led the rebellion to me. And for that, I thank you. But now you should join the likes of both Bill and the Undertaker. Your knowledge, your power, will belong to me.
That's enough.
What?
I said, that's enough! I've had enough. Enough of you. You, your torture, your abuse. It ends, Ace. It ends here.
You couldn't kill me. You don't have the guts to draw blood.
Perhaps you should ask the Undertaker. Oh, wait. She's dead. Besides, the look on your face says otherwise.
This is nothing compared to what I'm going to do to you.
I wouldn't say that if I were you. I might not have done so in the past. But I'm a changed man now, Ace. You can't even dream. I can do.
Likewise.
What?
You're a slight flaw in your plan, Absalom. You should never send the Undertaker back to me, Absalom. Now more powerful than ever.
Yes.
Alice, a puny little girl, I'm unstoppable now. Dreamland is and shall forever be mine.
Your reign of terror will end. You're over.
And who's gonna stop me? A pathetic excuse for rebellion? Ha!
Exactly.
Good riddance, Absalom. One brat down, one to go. So this is basically the end. This is the second to last scene before the movie was over. And we never shot this because it was honestly way too ambitious. It would start out with Ace walking out of the lair, see Alice waiting for him holding the Undertaker's scythe. They'd have this big, like, conversation, mainly filled with, like, one-liners. And then they start fighting. I had to plan for the fight being 3 phases. First phase, Ace just beats the crap out of her. Alice never lays a finger on him. Then Alice starts kind of damaging Ace. And then third phase, Ace basically gets destroyed. And it would end with this one-liner of Alice saying, "You're found guilty, off with your head," or something like that. And then Alice kills Ace. Then the Rebellion comes in and says, "Oh, we rescued Dom and you killed Ace, good job." And then they would go off to the hideout. Inside the hideout, Alice would find Absalom dead. It'd be all this big sad moment. Then Alice starts getting weak and faints. Allison wakes up at the entrance of Carol Woods, and they would have this kind of big touching moment where they say, "Oh, Alice, you can't stay here. You're fading out." Alice then says, "But I love it here. You're my friends." Then they ultimately agree that she has to go home. She has to wake up. So she goes into the forest. This big montage happens, and then she wakes up.
I'm home. Wait. I'm home.
And that is Dreamland. I hope you enjoyed what we had, and this commentary didn't get too distracting. This is a project I've been working on, as I said in the last video, for about 4 years now? I don't know, 3 to 4? And this project meant a lot to me. I'm just happy I finally got it out and for you to see what we had done at least. And I hope you really enjoyed this. For next week, I'll be coming back on camera and telling you what went wrong with Dreamland, what ultimately failed. You might be able to see from watching this and hearing me talk about it, but there's a lot more behind the scenes stuff that you need to understand. But with that, I hope you enjoyed this video. And I hope you look forward to next week's video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.